Hello everyone, bonjour tout le monde. Avant de commencer l'annonce ce matin, je veux dire quelques mots à propos des voyages et des déplacements. Nous sommes en discussion avec les compagnies aériennes canadiennes pour aider les Canadiens à rentrer chez eux. Nous aurons plus de détails à annoncer, mais je peux vous dire que le premier vol partira du Maroc en fin de semaine. Comme je l'ai annoncé mercredi, le Canada et les États-Unis ont conclu une entente pour interdire les déplacements non essentiels, particulièrement le tourisme. Le commerce et les échanges vont continuer. Cette mesure entrera en vigueur à minuit ce soir. Le ministre Blair donnera plus de détails plus tard aujourd'hui. De plus, le Canada et les États-Unis annoncent une entente mutuelle selon laquelle nous allons maintenant renvoyer les migrants irréguliers qui tentent de traverser la frontière. We're in discussion with Canadian Airlines to help Canadians stranded abroad come home. We will have more details to share, but the first flight will be picking up Canadians from Morocco this weekend. As I announced Wednesday, Canada and the United States have agreed to stop non-essential travel, specifically for tourism and recreation. Trade and commerce will continue. This takes effect at midnight tonight, and Minister Blair will give more details today. Further, today, Canada and the United States are announcing a reciprocal arrangement where we will now be returning irregular migrants who attempt to cross anywhere at the Canada-US border. Au cours de la dernière semaine, c'est tout le pays qui s'est mobilisé pour ralentir la propagation de la COVID-19. Des médecins et des infirmières à la retraite vont prêter main forte à l'hôpital. Les techniciens qui administrent les tests de dépistage et les chercheurs qui tentent de trouver un vaccin font des heures toujours plus longues. Et surtout, les gens suivent les recommandations émises par nos agences de santé publique. On se lave les mains régulièrement. On travaille de la maison et on limite au maximum les déplacements pour protéger notre santé et celle des autres. Mais ce n'est pas seulement les individus qui cherchent à aider leur communauté. Les entreprises aussi font leur part. Je pense par exemple aux épiceries qui ouvrent une heure plus tôt pour servir les gens les plus vulnérables, ou encore les entreprises manufacturières qui nous demandent si elles peuvent nous aider. Juste la semaine dernière, plusieurs compagnies à travers le pays ont contacté notre gouvernement pour offrir leur aide. Je tiens à les remercier pour leur solidarité et leur générosité. This week, many businesses put their hand up and asked us what they can do. So today, we're announcing a new strategy that will make it easier for companies to help out during this critical time. We are launching Canada's plan to mobilize industry to fight COVID-19 to ensure that we can quickly produce here in Canada the things we need. This initiative will help companies that are already making things like masks, ventilators, and hand sanitizer to massively scale up production. It will also provide support to those who want to retool their manufacturing facilities to contribute to this fight. For example, the Auto Parts Manufacturers Association reached out to us asking how they could help. Our healthcare professionals really need support, so our government will help these companies shift production from auto parts to medical supplies. We're also closing to reach agreements with several other companies, including Thornhill Medical, Medicom, and Spartan Bioscience. Minister Baines and Minister Anand will have more to say on this later today. Our government is also creating new, innovative procurement streams to allow more businesses to develop solutions and products Canadians need because of COVID-19. We will expedite these streams so firms can get to work quickly and these products are ready to use as soon as possible. Canada is home to some of the best innovators in the world, and with this new initiative, we will harness their talent and know-how to get through these challenging times. Aujourd'hui, on lance le plan de mobilisation de l'industrie contre la COVID-19 pour qu'on puisse produire rapidement, ici au Canada, les articles dont on a besoin. Grâce à ce plan, les entreprises qui fabriquent déjà des masques, des respirateurs et du désinfectant pour les mains vont pouvoir augmenter considérablement leur capacité de production. On va aussi soutenir ceux qui doivent s'acheter de l'équipement pour permettre à leurs usines de fabriquer les articles en demande. Par exemple, l'Association des fabricants de pièces d'automobile nous a demandé comment elle pouvait contribuer. Eh bien, nos professionnels de la santé ont vraiment besoin de notre soutien, donc notre gouvernement va aider ces compagnies à fabriquer de l'équipement médical au lieu de pièces d'auto. On est aussi en train de conclure des accords avec plusieurs autres entreprises, dont Thornhill Medical, Medicom et Spartan Bioscience. Les ministres Baines et Anand en auront plus à dire sur le sujet plus tard aujourd'hui. Notre gouvernement va aussi mettre en place des nouveaux processus d'appel d'offres innovateurs pour permettre à un plus grand nombre d'entreprises de développer des solutions et des produits dont les Canadiens ont besoin à cause de la COVID-19. On va mettre rapidement en place ce nouveau processus pour que les entreprises puissent se mettre au travail aussitôt que possible. Les innovateurs canadiens sont parmi les meilleurs au monde et avec cette nouvelle stratégie, on met en pratique leur savoir-faire et leur talent pour nous aider à passer à travers cette période difficile ensemble. Over the past week, Service Canada and many government agencies have received a historic number of calls from concerned Canadians. We received over 500,000 applications so far this week, compared to just under 27,000 applications for the same week last year. I know people are anxious to get the help they deserve, and our government is working as fast as possible to support them. This is, of course, an unprecedented situation, and it's putting a lot of pressure on our system, but we're on it. Thousands of public servants are working around the clock to help you. I know this past week has been hard on people for many reasons. Working from home while the kids are running around, not being able to visit your parents at their nursing home, not hanging out with your friends, it can take its toll. But it is in these challenging times that we also see what we're made of. This past week, no matter how difficult, was further proof that Canadians are generous, kind, and compassionate, and that should give us all hope. We all understand our responsibility as Canadians. We have to do the right thing, whether it's working from home or practicing social distancing, to protect our nurses, doctors, and everyone who works in our healthcare system. To deal with this crisis, we need everyone, citizens, businesses, and governments, to come together and do their part. And that's what we've seen right across the country. I want to thank all the workers who are stepping up and all the workers, all the companies who are making things our country needs. If you own a business and you're wondering what you can do, reach out. We need your help. Canadians need your help. And our government is ready to work with you to maximize your impact. I will end this morning by addressing all those celebrating Nowruz today and this past week. This is usually a time when friends and families gather around the half-seen table and share a festive meal, but this year is a bit different. To the many families who've been spending their first Nowruz without loved ones lost in the Ukraine International Airlines tragedy, know that all Canadians mourn with you. I also know that many have had to postpone festivities because of COVID-19, and I want to thank you for that as well. Social distancing is crucial in limiting the spread of the virus, and we do this now. Soon, we will be able to celebrate together. In the meantime, I want to wish you all a very happy New Year, Nowruz Itan Pirouz, and I look forward to marking the occasion with you again in the future.